Hello everybody and welcome to this new video about texturing effects with Krita. In the past video, I showed you how to understand better the pattern feature. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use photographs applied in the practical way to your artworks, how you can create your own textures based on photographs or your illustrations, how to modify with the filter layers, and how to apply mask to the filter layers. And also, I'm going to show you how to normalize the values on whatever image you have to use it as a texture and create a better seamless effect. And also, I'm going to show you how to use even scripts. Krita has default scripts that you can modify to create whatever you want. If you know how to use the script language, you can create even more amazing things with the script language. Isn't it cool? I think this deserves your attention. So stay with me, because here we go. Okay, let's go with the texture. You can do it in a very different ways. So I use, for example, this, and I insert as a new layer. And you can see I can play with opacity. I can locate where I want to place the effect, for example, of this brush stroke. Now I decide the blending mode, and I go here, and for example, I use the soft light, which works pretty well. And you see you have impasto in a few seconds. But there is another way, that is using the patterns. So to do that, I can create a new layer, and I go here, and I select a pattern, this icon placed here, and I see that, for example, I can use this texture or canvas or whatever, edit and fill with pattern. So it's going to fill my image with this texture, and I can use again the overlay, multiply, whatever you want to use. For example, I can select the overlay, and you see how it's increasing the contrast, and I can reduce the opacity until I find the right balance. And you got texture, but you are not creating a texture too rough. Now imagine I need to rescale my image. So I'm going to cut this, and I'm going to allow this to grow to increase the width and height, and it creates something like this. So what happens? Where is the texture? If I go to the background, I can fill with this color. For example, I go with the B key and I select this color. I drag this color to the empty canvas in the layer called background, and you get something like this, but you can see the texture. So to avoid that, we're going to remove this paint layer, and now there is no texture, but we can create it, because if I drag a color like this to the layer docker, you can see how I'm creating a fill layer that now is filled with the color. But if I press F3, I go here and change for a pattern, and I get the same result. The benefit from this is that I can change the size, and I change the rotation inside the docker. So it is a very, very good way to modify things. Press OK, and I select soft light, and everything is here. So now if I rescale my canvas, doubling, you can see how the texture is going to be there, because it's a fill layer. It takes into account the image size to fill it with the pattern. Now imagine you want to convert this in a tileable texture. Okay, you can do it. For example, I'm going to rescale it. Go to scale to image, just 1000, and you have this. If I make it tileable with this wrap around mode, which is located here, view wrap around mode is the same. You can see that is, well, it's tileable, but it's not perfect tileable. So how can I fix that? If I go here, I locate the clone brush, and I go here, press the control to select the starting point, and I clone the areas that I want to mimic. If I want more whites here, and I am removing the seam, taking care, you get the idea of what is possible to create this kind of textures. You have all the parameters here. In the painting mode, you use the source paint move. It's important because I'm cloning this area, but I'm displacing my cloning area. Now I have this. I remove, Control A, and now I go here and I go to the custom pattern. Now I select the current layer or the entire image. Imagine this has more layers. Right now we can use the current layer, update, and use as pattern. I go to the window here and remove this fill layer. I'm going to crop this just for a moment to see better the effect. And now go to the edit. You can see that now it's selected. So edit, fill with pattern. And you see how you have your new pattern recently created, ready to be used as a texture. Isn't it cool, huh? Tileable, and you have any problem with this. And now let me show you an interesting trick, because you can use whatever image. You can see it's dark here or light here, but we can equalize the grays with this technique. I'm going to duplicate the layer. I'm going to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and look for a super high range of blur. You can see the main shapes here, but not the detail, and this is the point that we are looking for. So click OK and go here and train track, and you can see that if I apply the wraparound mode, so you can see everything is around the same gray. The overall tone is like just one gray. Perfect if we want to create papers, for example, canvas, or whatever surface you want to create. I hope you like it. Now you only have to remove these little seams that are a bit imperceptible if you want to get the perfect touch. And it's a good moment to show you, if I go to the image and go to the offset, I can just offset by 2. And now you can see it's seamless around this area, but I need to make seamless the center of the picture. So you prefer this technique, which is very known by photographers, texture makers, in another software. Here's how you can do in Krita. Now you only have to remove this with the clone tool, as in the previous exercise, and done. Now we're going to add a filter layer to see a beautiful effect with the patterns. So you go to here, filter layer, and this is not this effect, but I go to the artistic and go to the halftone, and you can see how we have the image, and now we are using the screen tone, but we can use the pattern also. So we can select any pattern, maybe this, the honeycomb, and you see the transform. So you can increase the size, decrease, do whatever you want. And the post-processing, you can increase the hardness or make it softer effect. This is like old vintage photograph. So patterns can create beautiful effects when we are using in a creative way. The honeycomb is included in the digital atelier. Okay, and you can see the effect. And of course I can reduce, and I combine in this effect. Now it's copy, but I can multiply, burn, or whatever I want. But I want to remove from the face. So just, you only need to paint the areas you want to keep or the areas you want to restore. And you have the pattern where you want. And if this is getting too dark, you can go here, go to the filter layer, and just, not the artistic, but the adjust, go to the color adjustment, and increase the curves, and you see that now it's much better. And this is very good because it's not destructive, so I can do whatever I want, but I come back here, press F3, and I have my curve to play with these settings. Also, let me introduce a super amazing feature that is real-time textures created by code. To use them, we go here to the fill layer and then select this section, and you can select the script here that is available, and you see the effect in the other side of the screen and in the preview For example, I'm going to use the Wolferas color Perlin noise. Just hit OK and have a beautiful noise. So if I just apply with the soft light effect, you can see this grainy effect, like printing effect. Of course, this is too big, so I'm going to the options. And now I am increasing the size of the noise. I'll click OK. This is soft light. And you see the effect.
If you think this is useful for you, please support Krita, because we need your support to create even better future for Krita software. And that's all for now. You know you have more videos in the channel, so stay with us, enjoy painting.